In the previous video, we had a look at how we can control the conversation using prompt templates. And if we look at this code, we've now instructed our model to return a list of 10 synonyms for a word provided by the user separated by commas. And in the response, we can see that list of comma separated words as well. But if we have a look at the type of this response by adding type to our print logic over here, and then let's run this code again, you will notice that the response is actually of type AI message. And within AI message, we have this content property that contains the response. And if we look at its type, it's of type string. But ideally, in this example, we would prefer to receive a Python list in the response instead. And another very common use case is that instead of receiving this AI message, we might want to receive a string instead. We can very easily format these responses using output parsers. And in this video, we will have a look at a few of the most popular output parsers in LangChain. Let's get started by creating a new file, and let's call it output parsers.py. Let's start by importing our environment variables by typing from.env import load.env, and then let's execute load.env. Let's also create our model by typing from LangChain OpenAI import chat OpenAI. Let's also go ahead and import our prompt template. So from LangChain core.prompts, let's import the chat prompt template. Let's create our model by typing model, which is equal to chat OpenAI. Let's specify the model as GPT 3.5 Turbo 1106. And let's also set the temperature to 0.7. And let's set our prompt equal to chat prompt template dot from messages. This accepts a list as input, and this is a list of tuples, the first being the system message. And for the value, let's keep it simple and just say something like, tell me a joke about the following subject. And then let's also set our human message, which is simply a variable called input. Then let's create our chain, which is equal to prompt, pipe, and our model. Let's set response equal to chain dot invoke. So let's pass in a value of input, which is equal to dog. So far, this is nothing new. And this is the exact same scenario that we created in a previous video. And if we now run this in the terminal by calling py output parsers.py, we get this AI message object back. Now, what we want to do is use an output parser to convert this AI message object to a string. And because we will be looking at a few output parsers in this video, I am going to refactor this code. So just above prompt, I'm going to create a new function and call it call string output parser. And I'm going to add the prompt definition to this function, as well as the chain and the response as well. And in fact, I'm going to replace response with return, like so. And then in the print statement, we will simply call this function and execute it. Let's test it in the terminal to make sure that this is still working. And it is. Now, let's have a look at how we can add an output parser to this simple example. First, we need to import the string output parser from LangChain. So let's add from LangChain core.outputParsers import the string output parser. Now we can simply copy this class, and just above chain, let's create a parser variable, which is equal to the string output parser class. We don't have to pass in any parameters. And now what we want to do is add this parser to our chain. And if we think about this for a second, the formatted prompt will be passed into the model. The model will then produce this output, and we then want to take this output and convert it into a string. And we briefly touched on this in the previous video, but how this syntax works is the first object in this chain will execute, and its output will be passed into the next object in the chain as input. So now we want to take the output from the model and then pass it into our parser. And that is actually all we have to do. So let's run this again in the terminal. And now instead of receiving the AI message object, we simply receive a string. And we can make sure that this is a string by adding type to this print statement. Then let's run this again. And indeed, this is now a string. Right, let's move on to a few more exciting examples. Let's comment out this print statement and let's create a new function. And let's call this call list output parser. And let's create our prompt, which is equal to the chat prompt template dot from messages. And again, we will pass in the system message. And for the list output parser, we will use the synonyms example again. So I'll add the text, generate a list of 10 synonyms for the following word, return the results as a comma separated list. And then for the human message, let's simply add a placeholder called input. You might recall from the prompt template example that this will return a list of comma separated words, but the type of the result is string. So we can actually use an output parser to convert that string into a Python list. Let's also go ahead and create our parser, which is equal to, and we need to import this parser from LangChain. So let's do that now. And what we want is this comma separated list output parser. Let's copy this name and let's assign that to our parser variable, like so. Now let's create our chain, which is equal to prompt pipe model pipe parser. And finally, let's return our chain dot invoke. Let's also pass in our value for input. And for this value, let's simply pass in happy. Now let's have a look at what we get back when we print this result. Let's print call list output parser and let's execute this. Let's also run this in the terminal by calling py output parser.py. And it seems like we are receiving a list of values, and we can ensure that this is a Python list by writing out the type as well. Let's run this in the terminal, and indeed, we now have a list that we can iterate through. Let's look at one more example, and this is a structure that's extremely useful, and that is a JSON structure. Let's call this function call JSON output parser, and let's create our prompt, which is equal to the chat prompt template dot from messages again. And let's pass in this list of tuples. The first one containing the value for the system message with a value of extract information from the following phrase. We will also provide some formatting instructions, and this will make sense in a second. Let's also add the human message with a placeholder of phrase. So what we want to do in this example is we will pass in a phrase like Max is 30 years old, and we are going to expect the model to extract the name and age from that phrase and then return a dictionary or a JSON-like structure back to us. Now, in order for the model to understand how to extract the information and assign it to the dictionary properties, we need to provide it with formatting instructions. But don't worry, we won't have to manually type out those instructions, but they will be generated for us by using a Pydantic class. This will all make sense in a second, I promise. First, let's import this JSON output parser from LangChain. So from the output parsers, let's also import the JSON output parser. Let's create our parser and set that equal to this JSON output parser. Now this parser expects us to pass in the definition or the schema of that JSON structure. And the way in which we can easily define that structure is by using this Pydantic object. So let's import two more things from LangChain. Let's say from LangChain underscore core dot Pydantic v1, import the base model as well as field. And then in our function, let's go ahead and define that JSON schema. We can do that by creating a class. I'll just call mine person, and this class will inherit from the base model class. And now we can define the fields for this JSON structure. We want to extract the name and the age, so let's create the name field. We can also type it by setting a value like string or integer or list, etc. Let's set this name as a string, which is equal to field, and field takes in a description as a property, and now we can set this equal to something like the name of the person. And this will be used by the model to figure out what type of information should be added to this field. Let's also add age, and this is of type integer, and this is equal to field, and for the description, let's say, the age of the person. This is all we need for our example, but of course, you can make this as complicated as you want, and you can even have nested dictionaries in the structure. For example, let's say we also needed address information, which we can set equal to a dictionary, and so on. Now, for our output parser, we need to provide the pedantic object value, which is person, in this case. And that is actually all we have to do. So let's also create our chain. Let's chain our prompt and our model and our parser, like so. Then let's return chain.invoke. And this time we called our variable phrase and let's pass in a value like max is 30 years old. And at the bottom of our code, let's invoke this by calling print and call JSON output parser and let's run this. And let's also run this in the terminal. And we do get an error message because I forgot to provide this format instructions. And if we just have a look at this prompt template again, it's referring to this value over here. We don't want to type out those formatting instructions manually, but we want those instructions to be dynamically created by this pedantic object. So in our invoke method, let's also pass in the format instructions, and the value of this field will be generated by parser.getFormatInstructions, which we need to execute. This getFormatInstructions will intelligently generate an instruction which the model will understand. Now, let's run this again in the terminal, and this time we should get the correct response. And this time we do receive a dictionary containing the name and the age. Let's have a look at one more fun example. Let's provide a prompt like the ingredients for a margarita pizza are tomatoes, onions, cheese, basil, and whatever else. Now, let's change this structure a bit to say recipe, and let's change age to ingredients. And instead of this being an integer, we actually want to receive a list of values. And for recipe, let's change the description to the name of the recipe, like so. And for the list, let's just change this to ingredients. Now, watch what happens when we run this again. We receive a dictionary as expected, and the model was able to intelligently extract the recipe as margarita pizza. And for ingredients, we are now receiving a Python list. How awesome is that?